Welcome back to my channel. So here I have two of the latest Mythographic coloring books. I have a Mythographic Cosmic Spirit, which just came out not too long ago, maybe a couple weeks ago. And then I have the Mythographic Magical Earth. These are my first Mythographic books. And I just have to say that I have been kind of admiring these Mythographic books from afar for quite a while now, a few years. And I have just held off on buying any. These are my first two. And the reason for that was I didn't really care for the hidden objects in them, to be perfectly honest. I had already bought, you know, Kirby Roseanne's books that have the hidden objects in them, and they were kind of, you know, not really my favorite thing to color, so I didn't want to buy more books that also had hidden objects. But recently, I believe that they have stopped printing the pages with the hidden objects inside of them. And so I became more interested. And then when I saw this Cosmic Spirit book come out, I was like, oh yes, that's for me. I definitely have to get that. Yeah, I have a tendency to gravitate to mystic kind of things. So yeah, that's why I was like, when I saw a couple of flip throughs on Mythographic Cosmic Spirit, I knew I had to get it. And the Magical Earth book as well. Anything that has to do with nature, I'm totally into. And so both of these books I have yet to color in because, like I said, I just received them not too long ago. So today I wanted to dive in to Cosmic Spirit. And there's a specific page that I picked out for coloring today. And it's this page here. And this is, I looked it up because I'm not super up on knowledge about tarot cards, but I even printed out some information about this specific tarot card. It's the Wheel of Fortune. And I'll just quickly read a few sentences about this page, just to kind of give a little bit of background about the meaning behind this specific image. It says, the Wheel of Fortune reminds you that the wheel is always turning in life and is in constant state of change. If you're going through a difficult time, rest assured that it will get better from here. Good luck, good fortune will make their return in time. The Wheel of Fortune is also known as the Wheel of Karma and reminds you that what goes around comes around. Be kind and loving to others, and they'll be kind and loving to you. So if you want happiness and abundance, make sure you're sending out that positive juju in kind, and what you send out into the universe will come back your way. So I thought, well, you know, it has to do with luck. Also, you see the four-leaf clovers in here, and that kind of ties in with the month of March. And yeah. So my approach with this page is going to be using Derwent Inktense and my Prismacolor pencils. So I'm going to use Derwent Inktense for the background, and I think I'm going to do a base layer for the dragon with the Inktense as well. And as far as my plan for this page, that's kind of all I have planned so far. So we'll just have to see where the page takes me. And yeah, so let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, so just a little heads up here. Don't color this part that I just colored within that circle frame around the dragon, because that is going to be colored gold. So just don't color that part like I did, because then you'll have to go back and erase it. Okay, so here I am going to start activating the Inktense. I've got my water brushes there. I grabbed two sizes because I wasn't sure which size I would need. But I'm using this kind of a clear plastic. It's a cutting mat that I got at the dollar store. Got it a while back, but it just occurred to me that that would be the perfect little tool for placing my hand on, as well as laying my damp paper towel on. So I still have more background to lay down with the Inktense inside the circle there in the center, but I was anxious to see how these colors were going to look. So I went ahead and started activating all around the outside of the dragon. And then I will go back in and finish the inside of the circle. So as far as the activation technique I use, especially for small places like this, is just kind of going in as best as you can, little circular motions. And that helps activate those Inktense pencils and dissolves the pencil strokes that you can see on the paper. Yeah, so here is where I realized I had made that little bit of a boo-boo with laying down that Inktense. And this circle frame, for lack of a better term to call it, I don't know what to call it, I was going to make gold. So I'm going to go back in. I tried to erase the Inktense the best that I could. Obviously, it erases much better before activation, so I had started activating it, and then I realized, wait a minute, this color should not be here. So I tried to erase it the best I could, and then I'm going to be going back in a little bit later with my cadmium yellow and laying down a base layer of yellow. And I'm going to attempt to color it or cover it more with pencil work. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with how that background is looking. So I'm going to continue on with the rest of the background that's inside that dragon there, and just kind of continuing on with the colors that are on the outside and using that as a guide as to where to start placing the colors on the inside, if that makes sense. And then just randomly placing my colors down and making it a little bit darker in towards the center of the circle. All right, so I'm starting to lay down this base layer of cadmium yellow for the areas that I'm going to make gold. And I just kind of want to, I'm using kind of a light pressure because I don't want to have the cadmium gold too bright or too dark. So just kind of a light to light medium pressure just to lay down that color. Okay, so here I am laying down the base layer for the dragon, and I'm keeping the pressure really light towards the center of the dragon and darker or heavier pressure around the outside edges. That's going to help create the depth I'm going for. To kind of give that rounded look to the dragon. And we'll be going in with the pencils to create more definition and texture once the Inktense is dry. Also, I just want to mention that that star frame that is going over top of the dragon, it's okay if you get some Inktense on that because we're going to be going over that whole star frame in the center with my with the metallic gel pen. I'm using a metallic gold Posca pen for that, so it'll just cover it up anyway. So when activating the Inktense here on this dragon, I'm just doing my best at kind of keeping the light center light and the dark edges dark. So what I tend to do is kind of start from the center and push out towards the edges. So with this chartreuse, I'm just kind of staying in the mid-tone area, avoiding the highlight area in the center, just to give a little added depth and interest to the green color here of the dragon. All right, so this concludes part one for this page. I hope you're back for part two. It will be finishing the page. Have a great day, and thanks for watching.